Hello, myself Satnam Singh. In this session, we will discuss internal treatment to prevent scale formation in boilers. Water softening is a process of reducing the concentration of calcium and magnesium ions and to some extent of manganese and iron ions in water. Water used for industrial purposes should be sufficiently pure, that is free from calcium and magnesium salts. Hardness of boiler feed water results in scale and sludge formation, priming, foaming, and corrosions. That means hardness causes problems in boilers. Scales can restrict water flow in pipes. It is important to remove hardness causing salts from the boiler feed water. Modern day boilers have zero tolerance for hardness in water. There are methods, external conditioning and internal conditioning. External conditioning involves efficient softening of boiler feed water before the water is fed to the boiler. Internal conditioning, after subjecting water to external conditioning for removal of hardness, the residual hardness has to be removed using conditioning agents. It is carried out inside the boiler itself. By the addition of suitable chemicals to the boiler feed water, either to precipitate the scale forming impurities in the form of sludge that can be removed later on by blow down operation, or to convert them in the dissolved form that remains inside the water. Softening of hard water involves external conditioning or internal conditioning, also termed as sequestration. External conditioning methods are lime soda process, zeolite process, ion exchange process. Internal conditioning involves chemical methods and physical methods. Chemical methods involves carbonate conditioning, phosphate conditioning, chalcon conditioning, sodium aluminate conditioning, complexometric method. Physical methods involves colloidal conditioning, electrical conditioning. Internal conditioning methods to prevent scale formation in boilers. Chemical methods and physical methods. Chemical methods involves carbonate conditioning by the addition of sodium carbonate, phosphate conditioning by the addition of sodium phosphate, chalcon conditioning, addition of sodium hexametaphosphate, sodium aluminate to remove oil and silica, complexometric method using EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. Physical methods involve colloidal conditioning, that is spreading of organic compounds like tannin, agar gel, and electrical conditioning. Carbonate conditioning, it prevents precipitation of scale forming calcium sulfate in low pressure boilers by the addition of sodium carbonate. Calcium sulfate deposition as scale is prevented by the addition of sodium carbonate, which give rise to calcium carbonate, which is a loose sludge and can be removed by blow down operation. It cannot be used in high pressure boilers as sodium carbonate is hydrolyzed to sodium hydroxide that causes caustic embrittlement. sodium carbonate with water hydrolyzes to sodium hydroxide. Excess of sodium carbonate can result in caustic embrittlement, which is one of the troubles in boilers. Phosphate conditioning in high pressure boilers, by the addition of sodium phosphate reacts with hardness producing ions, forming calcium phosphate or magnesium phosphate. These are non-adherent soft sludge and can be removed by blow-down operation. Phosphate used can be mono, di, or trisodium phosphate. Calcium ions cannot precipitate below a pH of 9.5. Selection of phosphate is based on the pH of the boiler feed water. For example, trisodium phosphate is alkaline and it is used when alkalinity of boiler water is low. Chalcone conditioning. Chalcone is sodium hexametaphosphate, NaPO3 whole 6 times. It prevents scale and sludge formation. Chalcone dissociates to give Na4PO3 6 times 2 negative. This is a complex ion. It reacts with permanent hardness to give rise to soluble complex of calcium. Chalcone tablets are also used for cleaning drums of washing machines. We will compare chalcone conditioning versus phosphate conditioning. In chalcone conditioning, calcium sulfate, for example, reacts with chalcone to give soluble complex of calcium and it remains inside the boiler water. So chalcone forms soluble complex with calcium sulfate, thereby prevents the formation of scale and sludge in boilers. It does not cause any problem in the boilers. In case of phosphate conditioning, calcium ions with sodium phosphate give rise to calcium phosphate, which is a non-adherent soft sludge and it can be removed by a blow-down operation. So sodium phosphate is added to precipitate calcium phosphate. Although this precipitate is non-adherent and soft, yet it has to be removed by a blow-down operation. Now, if we try to compare chalcone conditioning versus phosphate conditioning, here we get a soluble complex of calcium which remains inside the boiler water and it is soluble. Here we get precipitate and these need to be removed by blow-down operation. Hence, chalcone conditioning is definitely better than phosphate conditioning. Treatment with sodium aluminate. Sodium aluminate with water gives rise to sodium hydroxide and gelatinous precipitate of aluminium hydroxide. This sodium hydroxide can further react with magnesium hardness to give magnesium hydroxide. Magnesium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide precipitates are gelatinous. They entrap finely suspended colloidal impurities, oil droplets, and silica. Loose precipitates are removed by a blow-down operation. In complexometric method, 1.5% alkaline pH is equal to 8.5. Solution of EDTA is added in complexometric method. Calcium or magnesium ions with EDTA forms calcium magnesium EDTA complex, which is stable and it is soluble in water. Hence, it does not create problem as far as scale and sludge formation is concerned. Physical methods. colloidal conditioning and electrical conditioning. Colloidal conditioning in low pressure boilers by the addition of kerosene, tannin, agar-agar. These substances form coating over the precipitates. Non-sticky and loose deposits are formed that can be removed by blow-down operation. In electrical conditioning, sealed glass bulbs containing mercury connected to a battery are kept rotating in the boiler. In boiler water, mercury bulbs emit electrical discharge, which prevents scale forming particles to adhere together to form scale. In summary, we have discussed internal treatment methods for water softening to prevent scale formation in boilers. Thanks for watching this video.